Very interesting and significant table. It is in Hebrew, but I will try to explain to you. Now, this table is on the minimal in the Torah, a sentence which said, Ketz Yisrael, end of Israel. Difficult to understand, but it is unfortunate. You know, the Hebrew word Israel means straight with God, Yasharkel. Sarekel, minister of God. Yashar, shirkel, singing to God, praising God. I mean, this is really the essence of Israel. But eventually, when people are doing exactly the opposite of the Torah, they're creating the Shabbos, not at all believe in God, unfortunately, they are like this. So, definitely, the great danger to the state, especially now that Iran is doing everything to destroy Israel, to wipe them out. 100,000 missiles against Israel. Now they are doing the bomb with the help of Biden. Yeah. And unfortunately, this is a very severe situation. So what I want to bring you first, very interesting idea of my book, Letters of Fire. A book which shows clearly how the world was created with Hebrew letters. It's in Bereshit bara Elohim et, in the beginning God created the Hebrew letters. They are the founding stones of the world. So amazing word in Hebrew is Bachor, elect. You see, Bachor, elect. The same letters, different position, represent positive and negative. Positive, racham, expanding, yeah? When you elect the right things, the right forces, you expand. But if, unfortunately, the election, you elect evil forces, especially against the Torah, so you bring destruction, charev, destruction, destroy, charev, unbelievable. Unbelievable phenomena. Let us see now what is going on in Israel in connection with the elections. So let us see what we have in the paper, unfortunately. The first thing, very recent news, a new study by Gesher found that every second Israeli believes that the secular ultra-Orthodox conflict is the most central and difficult conflict in Israeli society today and poses a danger to the state. Finally, it's exactly what is going on. Yeah, because this conflict, Lapid, Lieberman from one side and the religious Orthodox from the other side, is frightening. And look what is going on here. Yeah, former minister and member of Knesset for Israel, Betenu, Sufa Landwehr, she was a minister before, she attacked the party's chairman, Avigdor Lieberman, David Lieberman. And this is what she said, I am under pressure to shut up, but you have to know the truth. Landwehr said, Lieberman is a dictator. Everything should be done as per his requirement. He hates everyone. Today he hates the ultra-Orthodox. Yesterday, the Arabs. According to Landwehr, he is willing to throw the ultra-Orthodox in the trash. In fact, he said it clearly, you know. That's what he said. I mean, he said clearly that he's going to throw Netanyahu together with the Orthodox into the trash. Yeah, no, this is frightening. And people are voting for such one. He's a Russian, yeah? It's from Russia, and most people who are voting for him are not Jewish. Yeah, Russians. Russian people not at all mind that the ultra-Orthodox Netanyahu will soon, yeah? Because they want a Russian state. And ultra-Orthodox worker, this is a story what happened. At ultra-Orthodox worker at Kol Chai Radio was attacked this morning, it was Sunday, on a bus. Yeah, this person was from Far Chabad. And he went on the bus from Chabad to Bnei Brak. So he was attacked by a secular man who approached him and slammed him. And he said, because of you, the corona came. Frightening. And member Knesset Israel Eichler said on Lieberman's incitement, this is how it started in the Holocaust. And this is exactly what Lapid said. We don't read it, but the Lapid really says clearly that the religious Orthodox are people who are, they are taking bribery and they are doing everything, cheating and racist and everything, which the streamer in Germany said about Jews, frightening. This Lapid, you know, known to be like his father, very much anti-religious. So let us see here, anti-Orthodox, frightening, so people will vote for him, you know, so much more hatred will be to Jewish people and Eichler, member Knesset, say it will lead to Holocaust, you know. Lieberman said clearly that he will throw Netanyahu and the Orthodox into the rubbish, into this, no? Who knows what he can do more, he's a dictator. No? Exactly the things developed in Germany, the Holocaust, frightening. So let us see what the Torah, which is a blueprint of creation. And I said many times that many great things came and were revealed by the blueprint of the Torah. Amazing, you have here minimal, second minimal. Kes Israel. Kes is the end of Israel, also Israel, right? So what will bring to the end? Sinah, hatred, by Yair, the name of Lapid, Yair, also again, Lapid, frightening, this is his father. His father was called Tommy Yosef, also was very much against the Orthodox. He said he should support Yeshiva to learn Torah, and he managed really by this to join the coalition Netanyahu and to vote for Gush Katif, the expulsion of Katif, this is because of him. Yeah, frightening, but this was so much against the Torah. Then, what you have more here, so you have Lapid, Amalekite, because Amalekite has two faces, physical, he wants to destroy the Jewish people like Iran, Hezbollah, and all the others, and so spiritually, like Lapid, people are against the Torah, Lapid and Lieberman. They said, we can desecrate the Shabbos, we will give you transport on Shabbos, we'll be able to, we open coffees, everything you can Shabbos, desecration of Shabbos brought Amalek against Jews, yeah, no doubt. This is what is bringing out the great dangers. So what more we see in this table? So we see hatred to whom? To the Haredi. Haredi is Orthodox. So you have here Sinah to the Haredi, voluntarily. And also comes here the word that we saw in the introduction in my book, that this will bring Churban, this will bring destruction. We know that the second temple was destroyed because of hatred. Yeah, it's not Sinah Chinam. And this can bring to the destruction now, you know, the Arabs now. Who knows if the leftists, those people, right, will allow them to create a state, no? They will develop weapons and everything, and will they will destroy Israel. It says, they say clearly this is the one. They will start with the state, and then slowly, you know, they will build up weapons and all these things, and will finish Israel, Chas v'Shalom. Now, what is really the danger when in this year, Tavshin Peh Aleph, frightening. In this year, 5781, this is exactly what we see now, right? Iran becomes this, and who knows what will develop. Yeah, now with these people, Lapid and so, they are for the Palestinians. You know, they prefer, they love the Palestinians more than the Orthodox, you see. It is known. So what will be? So what will be? Our Rabbi said, the Torah says, tells us there will be a lot of troubles. And then Jews will realize clearly that only God can help them. You know, imagine that under thousands missiles suddenly they are threatening to throw on Israel. See, you must know the 6 days war was the same thing. Why most of people, many people, thousands of people came back to heart to believe in God because of the 6 days war. But the 6 days war was the same situation. Half of Tel Aviv was already was a cemetery because they believed that many Jews will be killed. And it was miracles. The same thing can be now also with Iran. The same story. So, hoping the Jews will do Teshuvah, you see Teshuvah, repentance, realizing that only God can help them, yeah? And then, as Maimonides, when Jews will do Teshuvah, will repent, return to the Torah, then Messiah, Mashiach, Messiah, will bring redemption, happiness, and joy to them. So interesting, a very significant table which goes, unfortunately, with the what you see in the internet news, yeah, frightening. Such a situation, you know, that the secular ultra-orthodox conflict is the most central and difficult conflict in Israel today and poses a danger to the state. A danger, yeah, definitely. Because Israel, people don't realize Israel is straight with God, yeah? Praising God, exactly what Jews are supposed to do, but you have this, the Lapid and these are doing the opposite, and Lieberman, and fighting, this is what he said, former minister, member of the Knesset for Israel Beiteinu, this is Sufa Lambda. Yeah, she attacks the party chairman of Victor Lieberman, even, you know, most of the people who are voting for him are not Jewish, are Russian. Yeah, so she said, I am under pressure to shut up. Now, this Israel are very good at this shutting up of people's mouths. But you have to know the truth. Landwehr said Lieberman is a dictator, no doubt, you can see. He caused the third, the second, the third the Lieberman elections, yeah? He said, yeah, Netanyahu couldn't be, yeah? So everything should be done as per his requirement. He hates everybody. Today, he hates the ultra-Orthodox, we know quite well. Yes, it is. And according to Landwehr, it is not according to her, you can see it. In the internet, he said clearly that he will throw the ultra-Orthodox together with Netanyahu and Netresh. Yeah, this, somebody said Netanyahu, you know, how much he gave to the country. In the beginning, he was very good friend of Netanyahu, you know the story. Yeah, but very fond also with the Orthodox, but somehow, maybe so many Russians, you know, and the Russians don't like so much the Orthodox, and it's only also, it changed, you know, it changed its color, yeah. So, unbelievable, this is the situation. Yeah, and this is what happened, it is one case of many, by the way, that an ultra-Orthodox worker at Kol Chai Radio was attacked this morning to study on a bus. She went from Kfar Chabad to Bnei Brak by a secular man. Secular man came up, started slamming him and hitting him, yeah, approached him and slammed him and said, you are guilty because of you. The corona came, you know. Now in the old city, in the Bnei Brak, in this city, the less of all. Yeah, okay, it was. Right? Because there are many families, well, every family have 8, 10 children, so no surprises in the beginning, was, but later on, they were better than the others, no doubt. And the secular places, like this gymnasia, yeah, a lot of people. But it's like the Germans said, the Jews are guilty in everything. Everything, all the troubles in the world is because of Jews. Yeah, but no, you can read the steamer. So what Lapid did, he translated from German to Hebrew, frightening. This is what you have in Israel. And member of the Knesset of Israel, Eichler, he said about Lieberman incitement, this is how it started in the Holocaust, exactly. This is how it started. First, that Jews are dangerous, all interested, all the things, yeah. And this came to the end, you know. So Lieberman, meantime, said that he's going to throw the Orthodox and Netanyahu to the flesh, but who knows how we can do it also in very, very, very different ways. So, unfortunately, this is Israel. This is our rabbi tell us. When Jews leave the Torah, they don't live according to the Torah. So, it's come to such a level, which is the reverse, sometimes from the attitude of non-Jews to this. Unfortunately, it's difficult to hear about. You know, in Israel, difficult for people, yeah, religious orders people to go on the street, and they have to be careful, you know, who knows what people will do to them, the secular. So, let us hope that really it is written here that as a result of this situation, Jews, not one from two, but one from one, will realize that this conflict can bring to the destruction of Israel, and they will keep the Torah, keep the Shabbos. Yeah, you have it still, Shmartim et HaShabbat. The Torah tells you clearly, if you want to exist, Shmartim et HaShabbat, Ki Ani Hashem, became my God, and so on. And then, only then, if we keep the Kol HaChukim, all the laws and the judgment, then we'll have happiness and joy. This is what the Torah says. You want to live in Israel, insecure, no problem. So then Tishmerun, you should keep Tishmerun Lasot Ba'aretz, do the commandments of the land. Not, it is not only for Israel, it is for the land, from Israel. So important and significant table for our time.